Hello dear students, today again we are meeting here to have another very important topic from the written writing skill, that is, do schools really kill creativity, or we can say mind mapping. Here I am again, Sonali More from Department of English from New English High School and Junior College. The topic here gives you will be having from 3.2, do schools really kill creativity, mind mapping. Here students, you will be having writing skills based on what you have to do. You have to frame, design, you have to develop the ideas from the given points, or you have to make the branches or the sub branches or the tertiary branches from the given question. Let's have an introduction of mind mapping. Mind maps are the tools which enables you to visually structure your ideas to enable better registration and swift recall. A mind map is a diagram, usually a non-linear graphical layout, that allows the user to build a detailed free-flowing framework around a central concept idea. Or we can say whatever the question you have been asked, and it has been told you have to make a mind mapping from the following question. So it is whatever you feel the form, you feel you have to make as it in the tree diagram. There are many types of diagram that you have to make from this particular question. There are multiple ways of making mind maps. What is common to all of them through is that they can turn a large chunks of information into a relatable and concise diagram. Means whatever the big thing which you are going to keep in front of, that is represented in the form of diagram. It is very easy to understood, it is very easy to get it mug up, or we can say it is very presentable. Concise diagram which has color code, arms and the labels and the sub labels as desired. Mind maps are aligned to your brain natural way of doing things. Mind map does not require for you to think in order. Your ideas should be fire as they come and can be revised and recognized as need be. A visual example will help you understand it better. Just like we can say, one diagram I have made over here, that tells you about the creativity. Creativity, we can say the main thing in that, it is what is our objective, what we want to innovate. Next is incisive. Next is energetic. In what form we are going to represent that particular diagram, what energy we have put in placing that mind map. Imaginative. Your imaginative thinking shows over here in what form of diagram you have represented. And the next is passionate. Here you have one icebreaker for you to get it solved. Complete the given blank space balloons with your ideas in the figure that describes your basic preparation for the HSC board examination. Also complete the activities that follow. Here I have made that diagram along with the answers. First we will take from the yellow figure, that is preparing for the HSC board examination. We will start from right to left. It is for preparing for the HSC board examination we require through the reading of all the test book throughout. It means whatever the things has been there that we have to go through with all the text while appearing for the examination. Next is create reference notes of every chapter. Some students have the habit of preparing notes in their notebook. Some students have the habit of preparing notes in itself in the test book. We can say some in the margin. Next is read suggested resources as reference online and offline. It means some like to go for the references through the various part, that is like an online and offline. Next we can see over here, solve the practice exercise from the textbook as well as reference material. most of them, they have the habit, whatever the things has been given in the test book, they try to solve after the completing the chapter. If they got it over, they go for the another references or the other references book for solving the material. That everything we do it for the preparing for our HSC board examination. Making a list of doubts for every subject. It is true, we used to do these things, all the things while we are appearing or preparing for the exams. Attend all the revision and the doubt solving session. Solve all the possible mocks, papers and previous year's question paper. As I have told you, we go with the various references on that time. We try to solve the back papers or the previous question papers, we can say over here, to getting faster in the examination. Be disciplined, eat healthy, sleep well and follow the study plan. These all things we have to prepare for the board examination. What it says, this is an one mind map which many things are has been spoken over here, many things has been keep in front of you, but in the form of, in a very very effective manner, that is we can say in the form of mind mapping. Next activity we were having over here, complete a similar type of detailed graphical figure in your own style, showing thoughts, ideas, concepts that keep on generating in your mind, and then you choose a particular style design or a graphical representation to describe the same idea, fact, situation. Then this type of presentation can be called as an mind mapping. The particular question has been taken from your text only. Use the different shapes, arrows, lines, connectors, balloons, boxes, curve, arrows, calots, scribbles, scrolls, explosion, etc. to describe your point of view. I have taken over here one diagram over here, just like, and I have taken in the form of balloon, I can say, or the circle. Career choose after the standard 12th. First is graphic design, nature photography, adventure sports and instructor, food scientist, fitness management, ethical hacking, creator artist, travel writing. We'll have a look on some of the tabular column over here given in your text also, that says you to tell your partner the importance of each given below. Enhance the activities with the mind mapping. We can say explore new ideas and the concept. What it says over here, let's look. Help students get a better understanding of new ideas by having them create a mind map. A mind map can assist with understanding because it conveys hierarchy and relationships, allowing students to see a big picture. We can say next is brainstorming. Generally, this method has been used in the lower level classes also. Great creative juice flowing with the mind mapping. Mind maps are a great brainstorming tool and can help students let their thoughts flow freely while making important connections between ideas and concepts. Next is, as I told you over here, taking a notes. Taking a notes, it means encouraging students to engage in active thinking instead of transcription by using mind maps for note taking. Mind maps encourage students to focus on keywords and the ideas instead of just writing down what the teacher says. It means they jot it down, or they can whatever the has been given the explanation, they take out the notes from them. Write essays. Students can create an essay outline, gather argument and quote, or a brainstorm ideas for your essay with the mind maps. Memorizing information. Mind maps activate many levels of brain activity and are a great tool to help with memorization, from the vocabulary words to a foreign language. Mind mapping is that form, we can say, when we are keeping in front of in the form of diagram, or we can say in the form of tree diagram, the things goes in our mind very easily and quickly. That we can say it is very useful method which has been used by some of the teachers for some of the topics in the classroom. Create presentation. Have student use mind maps to present information in an interesting and engaging way with mind maps. Student can use mind mapping software to create a presentation in advance or create one of the spot during a live presentation. Study for an assessment. Mind maps are a great way for students to gather all the information that may be conveyed on an examination, including class notes, test books, chapters, and a reading list. Last one over here, execute group projects. By using a mind map, students can visualize what needs to be done and who needs to do it. Using an online mind mapping program is the best for group projects too. Students can easily share it. Here we'll discuss some of the things, that is different frames and design on mind mapping. We can say each mind map is based on a fundamental thinking process or linked to a specific cognitive skills and serves different purposes. A few popularly used design are, we can see over here, first one is circle maps, used in the contest setting and brainstorming, means makes use of concrete circles enclosed in a square which is the larger frame of reference. Next frame is over here is bubble maps, focus on describing using adjectives, grows radically from a central circle. Next design over here is flow map, ordering and sequencing, makes use of arrows and shapes placed in a logical order. It could either have a horizontal or vertical layout. Next design over here is brace map, depicting the whole of something and its parts. Use braces and brackets. Tree map, classifying and grouping, reads vertically from the central idea mentioned on the top. Next form is over here, that is frame. Double bubble map, comparing and contrasting using bubble maps which could have been made previously as well. Next frame is multi-flow map, useful in analyzing causes and effects. Let's have a look on the benefits of mind mapping. Mind mapping is a simple tool which enables us to use a graphical way to represent ideas and concepts. It is a visual thinking tool that helps in structuring information to better analyzing, recall, and generate new ideas. Mind mapping has multiple benefits. Just have a look on that. First one is extremely simple to learn and use, applicable to all areas of life, that we can say in the personal or professional, helps attain clarity of thoughts, promotes creativity, choice to customize it as per your topics liking, increase productivity, better time and resource management, strengthens memory by improving recall ability. Last one over here, enables meaningful learning, connects to one pre-existing knowledge and does not encouraging rote learning. Let's have a look on uses of mind mapping in note taking. Here are some of the uses of mind mapping are, it helps break down larger chunks of data in a smaller and more relatable proportions, gives an overview at one quick glance, engage both the left and right side of the brain, whole brain thinking, helps to create notes quickly and save time, gives abundant flexibility than the traditional note taking method, ensures that entire information is captured, is easier to read, grabs and go back to specific key points. Finding key points in traditional liner notes is a tedious task. Let's have a look on the difference between mind mapping and the concept mapping. The key difference between a concept mapping and mind mapping is the layout. Like, mind maps have a radical structure, whereas concept maps have a tree-like structure. Mind map focus on one particular concept, whereas concept maps focus on multiple ideas. See, it is a crisscross. Making a mind map is quicker and faster and simpler, as it can be based on abstract thinking. Concept maps, on the other hand, are usually based on real concepts and might be complicated in comparison. Students, have a look on one of the brainstorming which has been solved for you, or we can say one activity given in the text that I have solved for you. Create a mind map on the importance of mind map. A mind map is a tool which can help enhance productivity in various aspects of life. The following mind map is an attempt to capture the importance of the mind maps. We can say it is understood that we have to make the mind mapping on importance of mind map. As I have told you, it is divided into four: ideal generation, organization, understanding and recall. Ideal generation is further divided into two, that is individual and group. Organization is further divided into three parts, that is idea, concepts and facts. Whereas understanding says us about connections and fundamentals. And recalls gives us idea about simple, quick and accurate. Hope students, whatever the things has been discussed in mind mapping lecture, hope you have understood, and in your HSC paper you will follow the same rules and regulation for framing your diagram, and on the basis of that you have to solve the particular activity also. The following activity is: develop a mind map frame design to show the benefits of games and sports to the students. You can take the help of the following points in order to develop each of them into further branches. What the things which we can take the help of, that is an given over here. It is for the fitness, stamina, team spirit, sportsmanship, good behavior, killer instinct, will to win. That's it. Follow the things which has been told you in the lecture and prepare a mind mapping on the particular question. Hope you have understood the lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.